Please, somebody, my wife needs help.
What's wrong with your wife?
She gets sick when the weather's foul. Can't catch her breath, like cobwebs in her lungs. Our son Hindle makes a potion that lets her breathe. He's the only one who can make it, but he's joined that cult in the hills. Please, get to him and tell him what's wrong. Without that potion, she'll die.
Long, hungry night.
These people need food.
There are rams out in the hills. Good eating, cooks easy, and no lords around to kill you for poaching. Too dangerous to go hunting now. More likely to find mages than muck.
Good luck.
Luck won't go fat on your ribs.
What do you need to keep these refugees warm?
Blankets, warm clothes, all of it. These poor sods lost everything when the mages and the Templars went crazy. If we were in a village, I could just pinch a blanket off a clothesline and be fine. Out here, I'm sure the apostates have plenty of supplies, just haven't been able to find them.
Farewell.
And see you.
Mages and Templars don't seem to care who gets caught in their war. The refugees here are in dire need of help. If the war doesn't kill them, cold or starvation will.
What can you tell me about the man who's supposed to be getting horses for the Inquisition?
Horsemaster Dennett. He lives on a farm to the west. Tough old fella. We haven't heard from him. Best we can tell, he's holed up until the Mages and Templars are done killing each other.
What other problems do these refugees face?
We've got some injuries that go beyond stitches and elf fruit. I know healers are in short supply, but if you can find someone in Redcliffe to help us, it would save a lot of lives.
Is there anything we can do to help people deal with the cold?
I asked the Inquisition to send blankets. You'd think I was asking for a wagon of raw lyrium. A recruit named Whittle is trying to make what we can bring in last. If you have any ideas, talk to him across the road.
What can you tell me about the rebel mages?
The real rebels are up north in Redcliffe, dug in and taking care of their own. The ones out here are just apostates, locked up in the circles all these years, and now they've gone mad with power. The rebels in Redcliffe have washed their hands of them. I wish we could do the same.
Farewell.
And you as well.
could make camp here?
Nothing to report, sir. Place the skull out here, and for what purpose?
The skull illuminates certain objects in the distance. I am not familiar with such magic.
Of course, it had to be a skull that lights up creepy shit.
Watch yourself. Bandits up ahead. Or something, anyway. They're blocking the road.
You don't think they're bandits?
Bandits wait until people are vulnerable, then hit them fast so nobody escapes. These bastards show themselves too early. They care more about driving people away than taking loot. They're either stupid, or they're more than just bandits. And they're too well armed for stupid.
What can you tell me about the attackers on the road?
Several groups. Some of them with bows. They've got better armor than most around here. It's too many for us. If you head out there, careful you don't get flanked. They don't take prisoners.
Thanks for the warning.
Bandits ahead!
That's the last of them.
According to my research, the ancient elves may have set up wards near here. If we can find the artifacts they used, it may help strengthen this area against tears.
Thank you.
Duran Atishan. I did not expect to see another... Go in peace, then.
That's not normal fire.
I have heard of this, but never seen it before. It is called Veil Fire. It is a form of sympathetic magic, a memory of flame that burns in this world where the veil is thin.
Are interacting somehow with the flame from the torch.
There's an elven artifact nearby. Yes, the wards are helping to strengthen the veil. This area should be safer for travelers now.
Retreating. We must pursue.
Yeah!
I hear reconstruction is progressing well in Kirkwall.
I know things are bad there.
I wasn't trying to...
You weren't. So you decided to talk about it?
About its recovery.
What you're talking about are the buildings, and even that will take years. People...
Nothing to report, sir.
Up she goes.
Nothing to report, sir. Nothing to report, sir. Nothing to report, sir. Thank you.
Nice work taking care of the bandits. Corporate Vale will want to hear the good news.
That tower is impressive, even as a ruin. I wonder what dreams it might hold.
Thank you.
Redcliffe has seen more than its share of troubles. That the rebellion should play out here. The apostates have fled to the hills.
Templar bastards killed my husband and stole the ring from his finger. They deserve to die.
You're saying the Templars attacked your husband?
Aye. He was digging out a stump. The fools couldn't tell a shovel from a mage's staff. Had to be safe, they said. Rebels everywhere attacking by surprise, sick bastards. They took the ring I gave him on our wedding day in case it was magic.
Farewell.
Excuse me, have you seen another Inquisition scout? Elven woman, answers to Ritz.
You said your friend hasn't reported back.
Well, she was supposed to be checking on some apostates. I'm on duty here, or I'd go look for her.
I'll talk to you later.
This would make a good place to camp.
Nothing to report, sir.
This must be one of the supply caches Recruit Whittle wished us to find.
A Templar, I believe.
It must have been some time since the renegade Templars faced a mage of any talent.
Shouldn't we travel to Val Royo now, sir? The breach isn't going to close itself.
Indeed.
The sooner we obtain help for the breach, the better.
Red Lyrium. Whoever this dwarf was, he was in over his head.
Nothing to report, sir.
I have heard stories about you, Herald of Andraste. I am Enchanter Elendra. I hope you find a way to end this foolish war.
If you're a mage, why aren't you with the rebel mages?
I was an enchanter in the College of Equitarians. We wanted tolerance, not war. By rights, I am sworn to join the rebels. But I had friends among the Templars. I will not fight them. I know my own strength. I have no fear of demons. I will keep to myself and harm none.
I believe this is your phylactery. I found it on the body of a dead Templar named Matrin.
Ah. I suspected he died when he did not join me or send word. Maker curse the fools who started this war. And the fools who now fight it. Thank you. Matrin was important to me. Here, for your trouble.
The Inquisition could use the skills of a powerful mage.
If I wished to kill others, I would have joined the rebels. How is the Inquisition any better?
Farewell.
Thank you again. It is better to know.
Fighting between the mages and the Templars has cost too many innocent lives.
That's what the skull helped you find? Right. Not ominous at all.
Thank you.
must have done enough to draw the attention of the clerics by now. Shouldn't we meet with them?
I do not believe these are simply bandits. Their armor and training suggest something deeper.
Thank you.
Look at this. The apostates have gone mad with power.
The Templars aren't looking any better here.
If we are to secure the Alliance. Perhaps the Inquisition could determine the nature of these objects.
Nothing to report, sir.
So here we are, Elf. Cleaning up another human mess.
What would the Inquisition do without our stabilizing influence, Master Tetra?
I assume they'd just start burning things.
That does sound like most humans I know.
If you gentlemen are quite finished...
Now, don't get touchy. We're just here to let simple humans our help.
Before you cause everything to explode.
Again.